Now let us see about the projectile motion. Now what is trajectory of the particle? The trajectory of the particle means the path followed by the particle or object during its motion is called as the trajectory. The path followed by the particle during its motion is called as the trajectory. Suppose that the object is moving along this straight line, then its trajectory is straight line. Particle may move along the circle, then you can say the particle's trajectory is circular. The cricket ball hitted by the bat, that is, you know the example, how it follows its path. The cricket ball hitted by the bat, the path is like this. Now here it is the parabolic trajectory. Here it is parabolic trajectory. You also know elliptical trajectory. Earth is revolving the sun. Earth is revolving the sun in an elliptical manner here. Now these are the trajectories we have seen here. Now trajectory means path. हे लक्ष द्या. ट्रॅजेक्टरी म्हणजे काय असतो? पाथ. इथे बघा, हा स्ट्रेट लाईन पाथ मध्ये जातोय, हा सर्क्युलर पाथ आहे, हा पॅराबोलिक पाथ फॉलो करतोय. लाईक दिस, द पाथ फॉलोड बाय द ऑब्जेक्ट ड्युरिंग इट्स मोशन इज कॉल्ड एज इट्स ट्रॅजेक्टरी. नाउ वी हॅव द नंबर ऑफ एक्झाम्पल्स. सपोज वी हॅव टू गेट मँगोज फ्रॉम द ट्री. वी हॅव टू गेट द मँगोज फ्रॉम द ट्री. हियर इज युअर mango tree, suppose here, and we have to get it. Then you can see here, you can standing here somewhere here, and you can throw the stone towards that tree. That is, you can throw the stone and that will follow this path here. Some you can projected it with some initial velocity. You can project it with its some velocity and it may follow this path like this. The path of the particle or the stone thrown by you, suppose that is to be like this. It may touch to the stone or not, but you may throw it like this, no problem. Now here you are throwing the stone by number of ways here, and the trajectories are to be like this here. Now here such type of motions are known as the projectile motion. You have thrown the object. You have thrown the object vertically upward, we can see here, but at some angle other than 90 degrees. You can throw the object vertically upward at some angle other than 90 degrees. Like this. And this motion is called as the projectile motion. Cricket ball hitted by the bat. Cricket ball hitted by the bat. That follows this path here. It is also the projectile motion. It is also projectile motion. That is, you can see, or suppose you are in a plane and you can throw some object here, it follows the path like this. It is also the projectile motion. Now in this case, you have to throw the object or project the object with some initial velocity. You have to throw the object with some initial velocity. काहीतरी initial velocity ने आपण त्याला project करणार आहोत त्या ठिकाणी. तुम्ही stone throw करता की नाही vertically upward? साधं simple example आहे. दगड घ्या, झाडाला मारायचा आहे तुम्हाला. So that you can get fruit from it. That is, in that case, you can project that object with some initial velocity. Now, the initial velocity has two components, the horizontal components as well as vertical component. The initial velocity has two components, the horizontal components and vertical components. The object is moving under the influence of gravity. The object is moving under the influence of the gravity. These are the important things here in the projectile motion. The object is projected with some initial velocity. This initial velocity has two components, the horizontal components and the vertical components. बघा तुम्ही एखादा ऑब्जेक्ट असा जर वर्टिकली स्ट्रेट लाइन मध्ये थ्रो केला लाइक दिस तर ही प्रोजेक्टाइल मोशन होणार नाही. यू हैव टू थ्रो इट विथ सम एंगल विथ सम एट सम एंगल विथ द हॉरिजॉन्टल और दिस एंगल इज नॉट 90 डिग्री. दिस एंगल शुड नॉट बी 90 डिग्री. दैट इज यू हैव टू थ्रो द ऑब्जेक्ट वर्टिकली अपवर्ड एट सम एंगल अदर देन 90 डिग्री विथ द हॉरिजॉन्टल. लक्षात किंवा this initial velocity has two components. Initial velocity has two components, the horizontal component and second one is vertical component. This is one thing in case of projectile motion. Second thing is that the object is moving under the influence of the gravitational force. The object is moving under the influence of the gravity or acceleration due to gravity acting on that particle. Now here then we can define the projectile. Here the object in the flight, suppose the object, any object in the flight After being thrown with some initial velocity is called as the projectile. Now see here, this is one of the example here that we can throw this object like this and its trajectory here, this vertical object, vertical motion here is not the projectile motion. Here the motion followed by this blue object is the projectile motion. An object in a flight after being thrown with some velocity is called as the projectile. And in ya velocity madhe, now see here, in case of projectile, in case of projectile motion, you have to see here that the object is projected with some initial velocity and this initial velocity has two components. Initial velocity has two components, the horizontal components and the vertical components. Second thing का है, बगा initial velocity has two components, horizontal components and the vertical components. Another thing is here for the projectile motion that it is the object is moving under the influence of gravity. Now here we can define the projectile. An object in a flight after being thrown with some initial velocity is called as the projectile here and its motion is called as the projectile motion. Now let us, we can see about detail in about projectile motion. Now here suppose the object is here and this object is projected with some initial velocity and this initial velocity has x and y component. X components are along the x axis, y components are along the z axis. Well, now see here, the trajectory of the particle is like this. Here, this is the projectile motion. Now we can trace here the trajectory here. Suppose here this is the x axis and here it is y axis. Here it is y axis. Now then, that path followed by the particle that we have seen here. The path followed by the particle is that we shown here. It is parabolic path. Here, the object is initially here, and here we impart it the velocity, that is initial velocity, suppose u vector. The object is projected with initial velocity u vector. Now this initial velocity has two components, the horizontal components that we can show here and the vertical components here. Suppose the object is projected with some angle theta, at some angle theta with the horizontal. Now see, this is the initial velocity. Now then we can find out its horizontal and vertical components at t is equal to 0 here. बघा इथे सुरुवातीला तुम्ही त्याला इनिशियल वेलॉसिटी यू वेक्टर देताय. यू कॅन थ्रो द ऑब्जेक्ट विथ इनिशियल वेलॉसिटी यू वेक्टर, दॅट इज इट्स हॉरिजॉन्टल कंपोनेंट्स आर नाउ हियर. सपोज यू एक्स हियर अँड द वर्टिकल कंपोनेंट्स आर यू वाय. हॉरिजॉन्टल कंपोनेंट्स आर यू एक्स, दॅट इज अलॉंग द एक्स एक्सिस. And the vertical components are to be ui. Horizontal components upon represent to be ux, and the vertical components are to be ui. Now then, the horizontal components at t is equal to 0 is ux, and that we can find out its value from this triangle. या ट्रायंगल वरून आपण फाइंड आउट करू. बघा हियर इट इज यू वेक्टर ऑर यू वी कॅन सी हियर, वी कॅन राइट हियर फ्रॉम दिस फिगर कॉस थीटा इज इक्वल टू, कॉस थीटा इज इक्वल टू व्हाट वी हियर राइट हियर एडजेसेंट साइड दैट इज यू एक्स अपॉन हाइपोटेन्यूज दैट इज यू. देयरफॉर वी राइट हियर यू एक्स is equal to u cos. The horizontal components of the velocity at t is equal to 0 are ux is equal to u cos theta. So upon velocity cha horizontal components vx at t is equal to 0. At t is equal to 0. Kya samjha jala ux jara udya upon notation madhe to avoid the confusion. Now then, the vertical components are there. Here ui ha sudha tela parallel ait amule ha ui. Here we can write sin theta is equal to, sin theta is equal to front side, that is ui, upon hypotenuse, that is u. Therefore ui is equal to u sin theta. Ui is equal to u sin theta. Now here these are the horizontal components at t is equal to 0. These are the vertical components at t is equal to 0. Now we have seen in projectile motion, the object is moving under the influence of gravity. The object is moving under the influence of gravity. That means acceleration due to gravity acts on the particle. Acceleration due to gravity acts on the particle. The acceleration due to gravity is acting in vertically downward direction. And here the object is moving in upward direction here. Therefore, this acceleration acting on the particle is A is equal to minus G here. A is equal to minus G. Now here, the acceleration is acting in vertically downward direction. The acceleration acting on the object is in vertically downward direction. And therefore, we can write here A is equal to minus G. The horizontal component of the acceleration due to gravity are to be zero. Parantu vertical line madhe aktopa. And therefore, its horizontal components are zero. Therefore, the horizontal velocity remains constant. बघा हॉरिजॉन्टल वेलोसिटी कॉन्स्टंट का राहणार आहे या ठिकाणी हॉरिजॉन्टल वेलोसिटी रिमेन्स कॉन्स्टंट बिकॉज द एक्सेलरेशन ड्यू टू ग्रेविटी एक्ट इन वर्टिकल डायरेक्शन एंड देयरफॉर इन प्रोजेक्टाइल मोशन द हॉरिजॉन्टल वेलोसिटी इज नॉट अफेक्टेड इन द एब्सेंस ऑफ एनी अदर फोर्सेस जर एखादा दुसरा एअर रेजिस्टन्स किंवा कोणत्याही फोर्स त्याच्यावरती ऍक्ट होत नसेल तर त्यावेळेला मात्र हॉरिजॉन्टल वेलॉसिटी ही कॉन्स्टंट आहे आलं लक्षात सेकंड थिंग इज दॅट द एक्सलरेशन वर्टिकल एक्सलरेशन इज ऍक्टिंग ऑन द ऑब्जेक्ट अँड देअर फॉर द वर्टिकल वेलॉसिटी इज अफेक्टेड हियर नाउ इन दिस केस व्हेन द पार्टिकल इज मूव्हिंग अपवर्ड द वर्टिकल वेलॉसिटी इज डिक्रीज कारण एक्सेलरेशन ड्यू टू ग्रॅव्हिटी ही डाऊनवर्ड डायरेक्शन एक्सेलरेशन ड्यू टू ग्रॅव्हिटी इज ऍक्टिंग इन द डाऊनवर्ड डायरेक्शन अँड देअरफोर द वेलॉसिटी ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्ट इज व्हेन इट इज मूव्हिंग इन अपर डायरेक्शन तो डाऊनवर्डला येईल त्यावेळेला त्याची वेलॉसिटी इन्क्रीज लक्षात इन दिस केस व्हॉट वी सी हियर the horizontal component of the velocity in projectile motion the horizontal component of the velocity remains constant but the vertical component of the velocity changes because of this acceleration due to gravity mata mala sanga ya tikani jar object asel tar ya tikani त्याचे हॉरिजॉन्टल कंपोनेंट्स काय येतील वेलॉसिटीचे सेम दॅट इज यू कॉस थीटा पार्टिकल जरी इथे असेल तरी त्याची हॉरिजॉन्टल वेलॉसिटी ही यू कॉस थीटा लक्षात द हॉरिजॉन्टल कंपोनेंट ऑफ द वेलॉसिटी रिमेन्स कॉन्स्टंट द हॉरिजॉन्टल कंपोनेंट ऑफ द वेलॉसिटी रिमेन्स कॉन्स्टंट वाय because the acceleration due to gravity acts in vertical direction vertically downward direction but the vertical components are changes but the vertical components are changes now we can find out the components of the velocity at time t the components of the velocity at time t that we can have at t is equal to 0 these are the velocities at t is equal to t at t is equal to t at some point suppose here we considered here at this instant here the horizontal components are vx is equal to ux because horizontal components remains same that is u cos theta that is equal to u cos theta and the vertical components that is vy is equal to uy we have the equation kinematical equation v is equal to u plus at kinematical equation your v vector is equal to u vector plus a vector t. Now here we write that v y component of the velocity is equal to u y minus, because a is minus g into t. V y is equal to u y minus g t. That is, Vy is equal to Ui is u sine theta. Ui is equal to u sine theta minus gt. U sine theta minus gt. Now, these are the vertical components of the velocity at t instant. Vy is equal to u sin theta minus gt. And horizontal components, vx is equal to ux is equal to u cos theta. We can now find out the displacement of the. Now we have to find the displacement along the x-axis as well as along the y-axis. That we can consider here along the x-axis, that is fx is equal to velocity into time by using this relation. Fx is equal to ux into, that is equal to u cos theta into t. U cos theta into t. This is horizontal displacement. Vertical displacement Sy is equal to, you can use this relation. U means initial velocity. Vertical initial velocity is Uy. Uy into t minus, now the acceleration is acting in vertical direction. And that's why we write here minus 1 of gt square. Or Sy is equal to, Uy means u sine theta into t minus 1/2 t square. Now here, this is the displacement along the y direction. Here, this is the displacement along the x direction. At any time, you get at any time t.